What? What's happening?
Finir.
Oh, no, not unless Halfdan sent you.
Whoever you are, I want to know why there's no king on East Anglia's throne.
Because the man in question ain't been married yet. Once he is, East Anglia will have its king. And little else.
Which man?
You know, stranger, you interrupted a beautiful dream. I was sailing through Helheim, drifting on a ship of fire.
Dreams of death often run ahead of the real thing.
Oh! Wouldn't that be a burden off my shoulders? What business have you with the backwater king, anyway?
Danes from here attacked my clan. I want to know why, and how to make sure it never happens again.
Ah, that would be Ruid's clan. They killed the last man I put here, Adolstan. I suspect they'll do the same to our next monarch.
A Dane who can't keep the Danes in line. Not much of a steward, are you?
If I knew how, I'd have rid our lands of them long ago. Ruid's clan plagues us all, Dane and Saxon alike.
You are the sorriest soldier I've met in this country. Kick your king in the arse and fight back.
He needs more than a kicking. He's got nothing he should have to win this fight. No courage, no army, no charisma. If he wants to live longer than a season, he'll need the backing of his bride's family, which he hasn't. They loathe the maggot.
Who is he, your king maggot?
Oswald of Elmenham. He was King Edmund's counsel before the invasions. And like it or not, he's the last Saxon noble with any sway.
Why not crown a Dane instead?
Halfdan Jarl made it clear. He wants a Saxon king married to a Dane, for a greater show of unity. But Oswald's not the sort of man you'd chase into battle with a grin. He's soft, and the settled Danes don't trust him.
Where is he now? I'll get the measure of him, see what I can do.
You just missed him. He's headed for Elmenham just now, pleading once again for peace. If you go by the north gates and along the road, you may catch him.
I built myself a home here. Ruid's clan attacked us as well.
Oh, how nice to have a home to speak of, man. Mine was burned to the ground years ago. And by whom, I wonder?
Please, all of you, be we Dane or Saxon, we all want the same peace. With land to till and home to keep, without fear of Ruid's violence.
Till they break the peace with another bleeding raid.
Nonsense. Their homes are here now. Same as ours, our futures run together. Not apart.
So what are these Danes attacking us, eh? What will you do about them?
When I'm king... When I am your king, I'll set things right.
You will be king when I'm a flying troll.
A king should be harsher in tone with those who disrupt his kingdom.
I'm not yet king. So I'll listen to my people before deciding what tone to take.
I'm Eivor of the Raven Clan. Are you Oswald?
I am. You're not here to kill me, are you?
I'm not in the habit of killing kings, but I do like meeting them.
I am Oswald, yes, for as long as I can hold out.
So what happened here, Oswald?
A clan, led by a Dane called Ruid, attacked this morning. They've been sacking farms and hamlets across East Anglia for some time now, growing more brazen by the day.
Do they know this is Halfdan's land?
They must. They just don't care.
Their chaos has touched my home as well, and I'm here to see that it doesn't happen again. Lately, I've come to learn that you are the hook that all hopes hang upon. As king, you could unite all the Saxons and friendly Danes.
A minor weight to bear, isn't it?
Who else, if not a king, should bear it?
Travel with me, Eivor. We can discuss my tenuous future on the road home.
What begs your attention in Elmenham?
Wedding preparations. Mam is on guard as we ready my marriage to the Dane woman Valdis. She's a cousin of Halfdan's.
Good. A well-matched marriage can forge a strong alliance. So what's the holdup?
The holdup? I don't yet have permission to marry Valdis. Her brothers don't approve of me. Slow down. Something is not quite right here.
Hold. A smoke ahead.
That's Beatley. It could be the same men who attacked at the walls of Norwich.
Stay here.
Seidar can save you now. Go meet
it should be the last of these pig-faced cards. Oswald will be relieved to have this.
Ruid's clan. They left none alive.
God rest their souls. I'm needed at home to make yet another fruitless attempt to impress my betrothed family.
Show more grit than you're showing me now, and they may start to like you.
Yes, sorry, I'm just shaken. If you joined us at dinner, that might ease their minds a touch. Think about it. My doors are open to you.
I'd be happy to join you. Tell me when and where.
Wonderful. Visit us in Elmham whenever you have time.
It's worse here than I feared.
now!
Healthy scene in town. This Oswald has done well for himself.
Look there. A lone Dane. Can't trust that.
Shh. Be kind, yeah? As Christ would command.
Ladies, this is a day of peace and fraternity. I asked you here to Elmenham to offer my thanks and extend my generosity. Finir, our steward, to our guests of honor, Brothir and Brodir, and to my lovely bride-to-be, Valdis.
You get to plow our sister because Halfdan commands it. But you won't drag us into bed with you, you hear?
Brodir,
the last Saxon king we backed wasn't half as mushy as you, and we lost 150 men protecting his maggoty arse.
Brodir.
If you're going to be rude, then I must ask you to leave. This is my home, and won't be insulted here.
Is that why you've come? To back this thane who smells of goat shit and cheap pebbles?
I'm sorry, did you say something?
Do I bore you, Wolfkist?
I'm here to protect my clan. If that means helping your king secure his throne, well, so be it.
You'd be safer crowning the throne.
It's made of less wood than, this one.
We'd all be safer if you had the stones to stand up to Ruud's clan. Between the pair of you, I can't see a single nugget.
You watch your tongue, Wolfkist, or you'll find it freed of your face!
So easily wounded by words. Imagine the ruin my axe would inflict on your flaccid ego.
My flaccid what?
Please stop this!
You heard me.
That's it!
She called us flaccid!
Limp, weak, soft.
Ridiculous! Absurd!
This is no way to ensure I'll be clean.
So full of vigor again.
This is not how we settle disputes when we stand here.
Stop! All of you! That's enough fun for tonight.
If that's all you've got, it's little wonder East Anglia is in the state it is.
You are weak, sheepherder. Your Norse friend here can't change that. We are better off without a king.
Well, that's me done.
I think I prefer dream nonsense to these alehouse brawls.
What a waste of time and good mead. These brothers will never back me in my claim.
This dance is just beginning, Oswald. Get some rest. You'll need your energy.
And will I see you in the morning? We have much to discuss, I think.
I will find a place to lay my head.
And Eivor, if you can help me right this situation, you'll have a strong alliance with East Anglia. That much, I promise.
Ha ha ha!
Oswald has set out for the day. I should have a word with him.
Clear the mess in the longhouse and wake my brothers with the coldest water you can find. Eivor, good to see you.
You are Oswald's powerful bride-to-be, Baldus.
I'm not his. This marriage is to be an alliance, nothing more. Besides, the man can barely carry a sword or speak with conviction.
Oswald is many things, but a gifted leader, he is not. Still, of everyone I've met here, he is the only one willing to be responsible for the place.
I will leave you to your day. You can find Oswald by the docks, and watching the river calms him, apparently.
Ah, good morning. Up bright and early.
You can labor like a thrall, but you're no good with feasts. Not a good start for a king.
No, indeed. I find a solitary comfort in my menial labors. Not something a king should admit to, I suppose.
The brothers shamed you at dinner. It's your duty to answer their insults. Don't let the matter lay unresolved.
Oh, it was a petty row with henhouse wolves. I'd sooner answer the moo of a cow than worry about their insults. I have a wedding to plan and a kingdom to save. I haven't time to suffer fools.
They betrayed your hospitality, Oswald. Where I'm from, that's a grave insult.
Well, well! Here's the mud-soaked Saxon who's been taxing my patience.
Steward Finnair. I know I failed to impress at dinner yesterday eve, but fear not, the Danes will come around in time.
You stake claim to the throne, you dazed dog with no bone. If Lord Halfdan were here, he'd squeeze ale from a stone. Yelling, Finnair, my drenger! Stick this cur in the ground!
All mewling and spitting, here's Finnair the Hound. He has bark, but no bite. Just a puppy I've found.
What just happened?
That is flighting, Oswald. Using rhyme and rhythm to lay a man flat. Try it. Match his verse.
There's no man you can lead, you dunce of the thirds.
A glutton you are. Just stop eating your words.
Not bad. Not bad.
He's got the wit of a boar, so when he insults you, make him feel stupid.
When I'm done with you, cur, you'll be raven flock food.
But your brain's soaked in mead, and your...
head's made of wood.
Wood! Head's made of wood!
He's an ugly puss, so when he brags, hit him back with something about his looks.
I hail from the north, where the winters are season.
But you're foul. You're a blister. You're a
plague-ridden lesion.
Oh, yes, that's very good. Plague-ridden lesion.
Under all that tough posturing is a sniveling boy, so dig deep. When he brags, take a jab at his manhood.
I've sailed squalls and north winds. You, not even a breeze.
But the winds that you sail...
blow between both your knees.
Blow between both your... oh, you mean farting.
Oswald, my boy, you're useless without your raven. This one's wrong for the throne. He's too soft and too tame.
Hit him back and make it personal. Attack his mother.
When you crawled from the womb, you were ugly and lame. Your poor mother, she fainted away from the shame.
Well spoken. Before sword clash and blood flow, we destroy our enemies with well-timed words.
You have a talent for verse, I'll give you that. But how long will that silver tongue hold up against an iron axe?
Let's find out, Finnir. I challenge you to a home gang.
You don't mean that, Oswald.
That's a fight to settle disputes, no? A home gang.
A fight to the death, yes.
Let's talk it out, then.
Too late. The challenge has been made. But a fight against Finnir wouldn't be anything to boast about. You'll fight me.
Hold on, this is...
That said, I shouldn't be seen killing a Saxon in the streets of Elmenham.
There's a nice islet downriver, near Seahenge. The water will wash the blood clean away.
Prepare the square, and we'll meet you there. I hope you're ready.
Ugh, I have to be. Just give me a moment to mentally prepare.
Do not make us wait long. It would not be kingly.
Take me, Eivor. Our victories will awe the gods themselves.
Show me your valor in battle, and earn your place at the great table.
Shall we send twin this month?
Send on some gods,
upon these ancient timbers, tarred for preservation, to mark my sacred symbol and pinpoint the source of their power. As I pray, the Lord sends through me the voice of a holy spirit. It reverberates with the finery of ancient language, and I am made anew. Were these timbers carried by the Nephilim, barriers against invasions from afar? Please, Lord, let this truth shineth upon me as bright as your word doth.
made it. Now tussle with care, and go easy on a future king. He's the only man left who can claim the crown.
Kings are made, not born, Finian. So let us see what we can make of Oswald.
Done.
You've still got the touch for drawing a square.
I've been in East Anglia many summers now, but I'll always be a Dane.
Must we do this, Eivor?
Strength and courage are always a boon, Oswald. You'll need both if you want the Danes to accept you as king.
True strength comes from resolve, Eivor. It speaks to us, a stern voice from within.
I've never heard of talking guts, but a swift axe would silence that inner voice in seconds. You must be prepared.
Wait, you're unarmed.
Where's your resolve, Lord? Stop whining and attack me! We'll forge your king out of you yet.
Ah! Oh, is that too hard?
It was a good strike. Keep going. Don't hold back.
I'll battle you!
You expect the Danes to follow this pork belly?
I'm still breathing, aren't I?
Show me what you can do, Saxon.
Come now! Inspire us, King!
You want me to fight?
Never be king at this rate. Is this the best East Anglia has to offer?
Yes, and I'll prove it!
Come on, fight!
Finish this, Eivor! It pains me to watch!
I'll do what I need to do.
Eivor is the victor. But you've shown us something, Oswald.
Stay down, Oswald. That's enough.
I will not stay down!
You fought bravely. Not with great skill, but with spirit and courage. Always push back with everything you have. Even if you have to get dirty. Even if you must break the rules. Because there are no rules. Not if you answer challenge head-on. That's where honor lies.
Not winning the fight, but living through it!
A seaside brawl won't change the brothers' minds. Oswald must show results. Redress old wrongs. Fight back against Ruid and his men.
The raiders who attacked Beatley have a camp down the coast. The sooner we remove them, the better.
That would go a long way to building you up. And if you brought gifts for the brothers, spoils from the raid, they'd be in your debt.
Time to whet your blade, Oswald.
Eivor, I expect your longship crew could help with this attack.
Finnum dirgripar!
Sail! Catch the wind! Sing us a song. We can continue later.
No one has been willing to take a stand against Ruid's clan before. We're a kingdom of farmers and merchants.
Even farmers and merchants can fight when led by the right person.
I hope your faith in pig farmers is not misplaced, Abel.
There is work to do, yes. But we will rise to meet Ruid's clan. God will make certain of it.
Sigurd!
Some sort of armed camp!
Oh, a sacrifice to the hand!
We will mercy!
Bring!
They
aid you!
You fight well, Oswald. Does the threat of death drive your blade further? Whatever compels you.
How much longer, Dragon?
Be wary of troops. Don't fight. Don't beg!
To kill any stragglers.
Over here! That'll do nicely.
Find something?
There's a crate of hack silver here. More than enough to make everyone happy.
We'll take it to the ship.
A hard-won fight.
The first of many, Oswald. Have you the will to keep it up?
Gift to the brothers. I have more than enough wealth in Elmham to widen their eyes, but this will be a symbol of my commitment to our fight.
It's a good start. Take what riches you find to Norwich, then send for the brothers. I'll meet you there.
Livestock and a trophy from us.
No battle-dented Dane would ever follow this lump of lord into battle. I don't care how many shields he brings me.
You mean to say you refuse my gifts, Broder?
I don't have time for this.
It's a generous offering, brother. You'd be a fool to turn your back.
Refuse this and your shame will stain the name of your sons and their sons beyond.
Stay out of this, Wolfkist.
Take the gift. We have bigger problems.
One of Ruid's men?
Aye. Sniffing around the outer walls, looking for an easy way to slip a few dozen men inside.
If there's one scout, there will be more. Something you might have learned if you kept him alive.
I was passing water when he surprised me. It was either him or my plowsword.
Where did you find this one?
Just outside the Northwich walls, by the water's edge.
They'll be looking for points of entry to sneak a herd of raiders through.
Jesus. Find another scout. We'll question him.
I'll look around. The rest of you stay here and out of sight. If I find anyone suspicious, I'll bring him here.
Druid scouts would be camped near their boats outside the city walls. One of them will talk.
Wait! What are you doing? I'm just a pig farmer.
You are awfully well armed for... Stay down, muckworm. I have some friends who'd like to speak with you.
Put me down! I tell you, I'm a cow farmer. Let me go, Dane.
You said you were a pig farmer just moments ago.
It's not beyond reason. I tend to many livestock.
You are as Dane as I am. Save your breath, liar.
A fellow advent. My prices are competitive.
Yes, all right.
Look here.
Did Ruid send you to? Speak now, and you may live to see tomorrow.
Argar swine.
I won't make you any friends here.
A scolding like that is a mortal offense, boy. I killed the bastard. Don't give him time to act again.
I'll ask once more. Why were you lurking around Norwich's walls?
I came to pay my respects, Lord. To Oswald, the whimpering Saxon Ergi of East Anglia.
I could do that all day, you drooling blood bladder. Only give me a reason.
Lick my dunghole.
Here's the tongue I use for licking. How does it feel against your ass?
When the braziers lit at Dunwich, Ruid and his men will rally. They mean to attack Northwich by its weakest wall. You English Danes are soft as butter now. Ruid sends his blessing, lady. He'll see you again very soon.
That's enough to go on. Time to die.
That wasn't necessary.
He insulted you before everyone gathered here. You should have struck him down yourself.
I will not have blood spilt needlessly in my kingdom. This has to end.
Alive, this man was a risk.
Valdis. This man spoke as if he knew you.
Ruid was my husband.
Your husband? You're married already.
I was. We've been apart for 5 summers. I never expected to see him here, and I never wanted to.
East Anglia's prosperity depends on our safety and unity. With Ruid's clan stomping around, neither is possible. I must speak with him myself, man to man. There's no place for him in East Anglia. He must hear it from me.
Right. I'll start looking for a new king tomorrow. It was good to know you, Lord.
Ruid will eat your lungs for supper, Oswald. Steer clear of him.
If I'm to be a worthy king, I must meet the man who bedevils us. I'll light the brazier at Dunwich and face him when he comes.
You sure you want to do this? Meeting Ruid in the open comes with many risks.
It's the only way. We must face him head on, and we cannot waver.
Come, Oswald. We make for Dunwich.
And, of course, I will see the lot of you there as well. Else the songs of your cowardice will ring out over the generations. I'm sure you're heading to Dunwich any moment.
We'll be there, Eivor.
You don't speak for us, steward.
Need I remind you, Valdis, what Halfdan will do with us if East Anglia falls into Ruid's hands?
for Aegon. Each word, body, and strength, and center.
You can't raise the sail here.
Sing, my ravens.
Hearken well in Hall of Kings. On ocean speed my words gain wings. Odin's mead I forth will bring. For noble deeds thine honor sing. The brave man slain Valkyrie way.
Run up the sail!
Reward for strength to Valhall paid. Then horns resound the mighty hall.
Take the mast.
Take the mast.
For those who fight, for those who fall. For those who fight, for those who fall.
Mast up.
Reach his web of fear. Each man gets his hated
cheer. Sail out.
Search the warrior shield. Raven scan the battlefield. Raven scan the battlefield. The beaten blaze of trail of death. Glowing gaze upon the dead. And horns resounds the mighty horn. For those who fight, for those who fall. For those who fight and those who fall. Who fight for we who fall?
Get the sail in!
Cut, Miller!
Dunwich.
It is time to light the brazier.
I'll light it. You do the talking.
Brother Valdis and I will scout the dock. Make sure there are no surprises.
Oswald and I will hold here until the brazier is lit.
The front gate is heavily guarded. You'll not be walking in.
I'll find my own way.
We'll be watching you back.